In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, we gather now on the seventh Sunday of Easter. Our Lord Jesus has ascended into heaven, and now we await the coming of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. Let us pause now for a moment to truly prepare our hearts to celebrate these wondrous and sacred mysteries as we ask the Lord now to free us from our sins and fill us with the power of the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord Jesus, you intercede for us always now at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we, who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory, may experience, as he promised, until the end of the world, his abiding presence among us, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter stood up in the midst of the brothers. There was a group of about 120 persons in the one place. He said, "My brothers, the scripture had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit spoke beforehand through the mouth of David concerning Judas, who was the guide for those who arrested Jesus. He was numbered among us and was allotted a share in this ministry. For it is written in the book of the Psalms, 'May another take his office.' Therefore, it is necessary that one of the men who accompanied us the whole time, the Lord Jesus, came and went among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day on which he was taken up from us, become with us a witness to his resurrection." So they proposed two, Judas, called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which one of us to be chosen to take the place in this apostolic ministry from which Judas turned away to go to his own place. Then they gave lots to them, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was accounted among the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet, if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testify that the Father sent his Son as the Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me, and I guarded them, and none of them was lost, except the son of destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world, so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them, because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I send them into the world. And I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This past Thursday, we celebrated the solemnity of the ascension of our Lord Jesus into heaven. Jesus then promised to send the Holy Spirit to be with us always, which we will celebrate next Sunday on the great feast of Pentecost. This time between Ascension Thursday and Pentecost Sunday is kind of a mini Advent for the church. It is a time for us waiting for God to come again in power through the grace and the strength of the Holy Spirit. Just as the Holy Spirit came upon the apostles on that first Pentecost to empower them to go forth to preach the good news to all the world, so too that same Holy Spirit comes to each one of us to renew us and to strengthen us in our journey of faith. Today, we are reminded of the importance of prayer. It truly is the starting point for every good work. If we want to accomplish anything worthwhile in this life, we must indeed pray. In the Acts of the Apostles today, we learn that under the leadership of Peter, the apostles gathered to pray, asking the Lord to help them choose the one to replace Judas in their apostolic ministry, and we see how the Holy Spirit then, as a result, chose Matthias. I think we often misunderstand what it means to truly pray. We can take prayer for granted. Pray for me, we say to people during tough times, or we say, I'll pray for you, as we tell people when we encounter them that we're thinking about them, and that is all very well and good. But do we really get what prayer is? Sometimes I think we look at prayer as kind of a sacred wishing well. We toss in our hopes and our desires, and we wait to see what God will give us. God, help me get a raise. God, help me pass this test. God, make this medical test come back negative. And then we become disillusioned or disappointed when we don't get what we wanted, thinking God that has not heard us, that God has not answered us. But the truth is, God indeed hears every prayer. God does answer. Sometimes it's just not the answer that we wanted. Sometimes God gives us desires that can't be fulfilled, plans that can't be carried out, ideas that will never be what we hoped for. The raise doesn't come through, we fail the test, and the lab tests tell us what we didn't want to hear. It's hard to understand, sometimes impossible to accept, that a God who loves us so much allows these things in our lives. But the God who permits pain is the same God who knew the pain of watching his own son suffer and die on the cross. But there was a purpose, for out of that cross came resurrection, came Easter, and out of that came our salvation. I'm reminded of the beautiful Serenity Prayer. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. In John's Gospel today, we hear Jesus himself praying in that great priestly prayer at the Last Supper, a prayer to his Father. It is a prayer not for himself, but for his apostles. Holy Father, keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one just as we are one. Consecrate them in the truth, and as you send me into the world, so I send them into the world. My friends, I believe that night Jesus was not just praying for his apostles, but was praying for each and every one of us. He was praying for all of us across the centuries, all who believe, all who wonder, all who fear, and all who doubt. All of us who pray, we are his, and he is with us always, and we can never, ever forget that. One of the great writers of the last century, Flannery O'Connor, wrote a beautiful little book entitled A Prayer Journal. She died tragically young of lupus at the age of 39. Her journal contains some of the most honest, heartfelt prayers I have ever read. She said, "I would like to write a beautiful prayer." And then you realize she's talking about her life. And addressing her words to God, she pleads, "Don't let me ever think, dear God, that I was anything but the instrument for your story, just like the typewriter was mine. Take me, dear Lord, and set me in the direction I am to go." I can think of no other prayer more simple or more beautiful or more universal. It is another way of saying, "Thy will be done," which I think was undoubtedly the prayer of the apostles in those days before Pentecost, as they gathered with the Blessed Mother Mary in the upper room, waiting for something and someone they couldn't really name or explain. All of us, in one way or the other, are in our upper room, especially at this time as we continue to wait for things to open, for the pandemic to come to an end, especially for the places of our worship to open and to be able to gather safely with family and friends. My friends, let us make of these days and make of our lives a prayer of hope, confident in God's loving plan for each and every one of us. Thy will be done. The truth is, prayer changes things. We have to pray every day, and we have to trust that God holds the future of our lives in his loving hands, and his Holy Spirit will always be with us to empower us and to guide us. As Flannery O'Connor put it, we ask to be instruments of God's great story. More than ever, we need the Holy Spirit to come again and open wide the doors of the church. We need renewal in the church at every level, and it begins with renewal in our own hearts and minds and lives. And so we pray, come Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Amen. And together now we pray the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My sisters and brothers, confident in God's love and steadfast care, we bring our prayers and needs before him.
For the church, May she flourish in holiness as she gives witness to the glory of the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may the Holy Spirit inspire them in living by the truth and working for justice for all people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who struggle because of poverty, sickness, or violence within their communities, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newly baptized and confirmed, may the flame of the Holy Spirit grow within their hearts and minds. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have died, especially those who have no one else to remember or pray for them, may they know the fullness of life in the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we take confidence in knowing that your Son Jesus prayed for us. With hope in our hearts, we now join those prayers to his, knowing you will answer them according to your holy will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Through the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, wash my iniquities. Cleanse me from all of my sins.
Pray now, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be pleasing and acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our bishop, and all the clergy, the religious, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My friends, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And may that peace now enter your hearts and your homes and all with whom you share peace today. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Oh,
Let us pray. Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries, there will be accomplished in the body of the whole Church what has already come to pass in Christ, her head, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And let us pray now together the prayer of canonization for Father Nelson Baker.
Lord, you gave us your servant Nelson Baker as an example of service to the poor, homeless, and young. By Father Baker's ardent concern for those in need, inflame our hearts and lives with compassion for the poor, justice for the oppressed, hope for the troubled, and courage for those in doubt. We pray through the intercession of Our Lady of Victory, if it be your will, that your servant, Nelson Baker, may one day be canonized. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Our Lady of Victory,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go now in peace to glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.